student, I hope you are doing well. So today we are going to study our subject social study of class 3. Our chapter name is changes in the transport system. Okay, so children, basically we know about transportation. Okay, so how do you go to school every day? These are the basic things where we use transport system. Okay, so by school bus or by walk. You go to your school by school bus or by walk. Okay, now the second question is, if you have to go to another city to meet your friend, how will you do, children? Yes, by car or by walk or by bus. Okay, now third question is, if you have to go to another country to meet your cousin, how will you go? Of course, by airplane or by ships. So these are the transport. Today, now we are going to discuss types of transport. So there are three main types of transport. Which are they? Land transport, water transport, air transport. Now let's learn by book. Children, so let us learn more clearly about transportation today. Okay, we need to travel from one place to another all the time. We can walk to places which are very close. Okay, to go to place far, we have to use bicycle, rickshaw, scooter, car, bus, train, ship or airplane. Means of transport can carry both people and goods from one place to another. The kind of transport we choose will depend on the distance to be traveled, the money we can spend and the time available. Now, come to the chapter. From the earliest time, man has moved from one place to another. Earlier, it was in search of food, but after man became civilized, it was to find new land for farming and settlement. The wheel was invented thousands of years ago. It led to many other inventions. Today, cars, buses, trucks, aeroplanes, etc. all run on wheels. Transport has become an integral part of our day-to-day life. You can see what is written here. Tractor, bullock cart, truck, bus, monorail, tram. Now, most of the people in our country live in the villages. They still use bicycle, bullock carts, tractors, etc. for moving from one place to another. All these vehicles that are used in rural areas are called the means of rural transport. Vehicles that moves in town and cities are called the means of urban transport. They are buses, trucks, cars, trains, metro, trains, monorails, trams, aeroplane, etc. Okay, children, let's start. The first one is land transport. This is used for movement on land. Railways and roadways are the two major means of land transport. Railways in India are the largest in Asia. They provide job to the largest number of people in comparison to any other industry. They help to transport both passengers and goods. The first train in India ran between Mumbai and Thane in 1853. Today, we have electric and diesel trains, which provide all types of comfort to the passengers. Big cities like Delhi, Mumbai and Kolkata have metro trains, which run on either elevated tracks or underground tracks. These metro trains carry lakh of commuters daily within the cities. Now, Rajdhani Express and Shatabdi Express are two super fast trains of India. They have speed of about 140 kmph. In hilly areas like Simla, Darjeeling and Ooty, they are small trains which are called toy trains. Chennai,
Mumbai and Kolkata also have local trains to carry passengers from one part of the city to another. Local trains in Kolkata are called trams. There is a proposal to introduce monorails in some cities. Mumbai has already started monorail system. Recently, multimodal transport system MMTS has been introduced in Hyderabad. It is a suburban rail system. This is MMTS. You can see here, this is a Delhi. The government has decided to start bullet trains in India soon. These trains have speed of over 300 km per hour. The first bullet train will run between Ahmedabad and Mumbai. Another bullet train will run between Delhi and Mumbai. Now, let's read about roadways. Roadways are the most common way of connecting cities, towns, and villages with each other. It is easier to build and travel by roadways as compared to railway and airways. The Indian roads are divided into four divisions. The first one is national highways, expressways, and superhighways. The second one is state highways. And the third, district roads. Fourth one is rural roads or village roads. The major cities of our country are connected by national highways. Important towns and cities within a state are connected by state highways. Recently, 8-lane expressways or superhighways are being built to connect big cities and commercial centers. Golden quadrilateral superhighways connect Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai, and Kolkata. Now, water transport. Water provides slow means of transport, but covers both small distance across river and stream. So children, water transport what covers? It covers rivers and streams distance and large distance across ocean and seas. And it covers the distance between oceans and seas also. Big rivers like Ganga, Brahmaputra and Yamuna are also used for transporting people and goods. This is called inland water transport. The inland water in lagoons have boat and streamers, which transport people and carry large loads such as heavy machinery, automobile, etc. So means children, what we took by ships, we take loads such as heavy machinery, automobiles, etc. From one country to another, ships can sail only in deep water. Thus, seas have large harbors and ports. There are 12 big sea ports and over 140 small seaports in India. Mumbai ports is India's biggest port. This is steamer, this is motor boat, and this is ship. Now let's come on air transport. The transport system by which we can be run on by air. Okay, so air transport is a fastest means of transport. It was started in India and in 1911. Air transport is becoming very popular in India nowadays. There are many private domestic airlines in India such as Jet Airways, SpiceJet, Spice Airways, IndiGo. These are the private domestic airlines. Okay, now Air India carry flight to different parts of the country and the world. There are 11 big airports and small 50 small airports in India, which other than catering to passenger also have facilities to transport goods. Now, the major international airports of India are Delhi, which is Indira Gandhi International Airport. Second, Mumbai, which is Chhatrapati Shivaji International Airport. Third is Kolkata. The name of the airport is Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose International Airport. Fourth is Chennai, Menambakkam International Airport. We can say CN Anna Durai also to that airport. And Rajiv Gandhi Airport of Hyderabad. And Kempe Gowda International Airport of Bangalore. Now, Trivandrum International Airport of Thiruvananthapuram, Cochin International Airport of Kochi, Sri Guru Ramdas G International Airport of Amritsar, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel International Airport of Ahmedabad. Helicopter facilities are also available in India. The airplanes and helicopters have during flu and such other calamities. Airplanes and helicopter drop food items and other necessary items in food hit areas such as recently Uttarakhand to rescue pilgrims. Helicopters are used to play at places where airplanes cannot land. They are also used by the government for important activities. So, modern means of transport and efficient network of road, bridges and airport have led to the growth of tourism in the country. This has brought in a lot of foreign exchange and given employment to thousands of Indians. Children, now let us recall. Transport has become an integral part of our life. Railways are the major means of transport in India. Third, roadways are the most common ways of connecting cities, towns and villages. Fourth, there are 12 big and over 140 small seaports in India. Fifth, aeroplanes are the fastest and the costliest means of transport. Modern means of transport have helped in the growth of tourism. Soon, bullet train will start running in India. Since the last decades, many expressways and superhighways have been built. Okay, so children, our chapter is completed. If you are having any doubt with this, related to this chapter, please do comment on Facebook or YouTube channel. In the next section, I am going to share you the exercise of this chapter. Thank you.